Hello everyone, I would like to welcome you all in my class of CIS 3146 Embedded System. The focus of this session is on coursework 2 of Embedded System module, and it is a portfolio based coursework. In coursework 2, you will work on tutorial tasks. So what will happen in coursework 2, each week you will be given some task to work on. For this task, you will prepare a lab log and you will submit this lab log on Blackboard Dropbox. So this is what we are going to do. And the aim of this coursework is to showcase, you can showcase your understanding about the embedded system principles and architecture. So that is why this coursework 2 is given. The more information about the coursework 2 is given in the coming sections. So here you can see the weightage given for coursework 2, which is 50%. So the weightage for coursework 2 is 50%. As far as the hand-in date, that is the issue date of the task, and the submission deadline for the task can be seen in the Blackboard Dropbox area. Learning outcome 4 will be assessed. So when you will prepare your lab log, so your lab log for the task, it must reflect how you have achieved the learning outcome number 4. Now coming to introduction. You will prepare or maintain a portfolio of the tutorial work of weekly task, and your lab log includes reflective theme. So here the reflective theme is nothing but the learning outcome 4. So in what you have to do when you will prepare the lab log, you need to include the testing, you need to show how you have conducted the evaluation, you need to show critical comments, you need to show how you addressed problems that you have encountered while working on the task. So this is what you need to, these things you need to cover in your lab log for the weekly task. Now, specification and design is given in the next section, which is here. Coursework has two parts. So suppose you are working on task number 1. So for task 1, you need to prepare two documents. I'm calling it document D1 and document D2. Document D1 will be your lab log, and document D2 will be the solution or the answer you have prepared for the given problem. So problem is given in task 1, and this document, that is document D2, is the solution or the answer for the given problem, and document D1 will be the lab log. And what you have to do when you will work on a specific task, you need to present original exercise sheet, that is the lab log. If you are using any additional sheet to record your solution or answer, you need to add this sheet also, and then a completed log sheet you will submit, and the blank log sheet, that is the template of the log sheet, log sheet can be downloaded from the Blackboard. So you can get the template for the log sheet from the Blackboard, and you can fill this template for each week task. So this is what you will do in coursework 2. Now what you in your lab log for coursework 2, the first thing which you need to include in your lab log or practical session log is your name, your date and time. Then the second section will be the objective of lab session. Then the next section, that is section 3rd, will be description. This section will play a very, very important role. Here you will present the requirement for the given task. Then you will present the design for the given task. Then you will show some other thing like method or any algorithm you have implemented or you have created for solving the problem. Then you will include coding, and coding must be commented. Then you will record your output. So for the output, you can submit. You can use a screenshot to demonstrate your implementation, how you implemented and attempted the features. Then the next thing which you will include is evaluation. So how you evaluated your task and how you evaluated the your response. So for the evaluation, you can include testing which you conducted. If you have encountered any problem, then how you addressed the problem. So you need to cover all these things in your lab log under this evaluation section. Then you can include conclusion. In the conclusion section, you need to explain what you have learned from the weekly task. It is recommended that you include references, add references in your report to backup support your claims. If you are saying anything, so it must be supported by the reference. Now, for referencing, it is recommended that you use Harvard style. You can get more information about referencing using this URL. You need to follow standard academic writing style. More information can be seen here. As I said, you will prepare a lab log. So here it is said that you can get the template for practical session log from the Blackboard. Now, assessment guideline. For the assessment of your lab log, what will be assessed? Learning outcome 4 will be assessed. So your lab log must reflect how you have achieved learning outcome 4. And in order to achieve learning outcome 4, you need to cover these two attributes. The first one is contents and the presentation, and the second one is quality of your work. So these two attributes must be there in your lab log for each task. Now, this section is for the submission of the weekly task. So how you will submit? As I said, each week you will develop two documents, documents D1 and documents D2. And what is D1 and D2? I already explained here. So this is my D1, lab log and solution exercise is my D2. So this will be lab log and this one will be the answer of the problem. So you will prepare two documents, D1 and D2. So what you need to do? You need to put both the documents in one folder. Give the name to this folder as this, using this naming convention. So what you have to do, like I have given my name Pandey, my initial first name, that is H. I have taken some random student number, coursework2.jp. So you need to do this for each task. Task 1, two documents D1, D2, put in folder, give the name following this naming convention for this folder, and submit this using the Blackboard Dropbox. So this is what you will do for the submission. Next, I will show you the assessment criteria. So as I said, learning outcome 4 will be assessed. So that is why 100% weightage is given for the learning outcome 4. Here you can see the grading is given: pass, good, very good, excellent, and outstanding. You can see the marking range is given for this grade. Marking range, if 30 to 39, then this grade. If the marking range is between 40 to 49, then this range. If marking range is between 50 to 59, then grade will be good. If the marks is in between 60 to 69, then grade will be very good. If this range, that is 70 to 84, excellent, and this is, that is 85 plus, then you will get outstanding. The criteria for grading and feedback is given here. So you can see for fail, this is the marking criteria is this. For narrow fail, marking criteria is given here. So marking criteria you can read using this marking grid. So this is all about coursework 2. If you have any difficulty in understanding what you need to do in coursework 2, or if you want any further clarification, you can discuss during the tutorial session this week. Thank you very much.